Hello everyone. My today talk concerns high frequency response of biomass derived carbon in aqueous electrochemical capacita. The work was done in three different institutions, Poznan University of Technology, Slovenia, and University of Zaragoza. I want to speak about electrochemical capacita, but only about properties which are charging, discharging during 1 second. And everyone knows that electrochemical capacitor is a device of high specific power, which is not able to reach in the family of accumulators. Here you see some kind of a very basic formula for energy, power, and capacitance. You see the charging of and discharging of electrical double layer is based on electrostatic attraction of ions in electrode-electrolyte interface. Now, where we are using materials rich in nitrogen functionality, because nitrogen-doped carbons can have high conductivity because of modification of electron density, high capacitance because of redox processes which are observed on the right side, and because of wettability. We are preparing our materials as the following. Adenine was a precursor, and we are using salt templating synthesis, where KCl was playing a role of template, whereas the chloride of zinc was activator. Salt to salt ratio was 1:1, whereas salt to precursor ratio was 10:1. Such kind of mixture was after pyrolyzed in oven at 900 degrees C. And on the right, you see scanning electron microscopy of this material. And the electrode material was composed on activated carbon, Teflon, and carbon black. One molybdenum sulfate played a role of electrolytic solution. Here you see transmission electron microscopy images of both carbons because adenine was our carbon prepared as a new one, and it was compared to YP50F, which is typical industrial carbon produced by Kurari, Japan. So you see that here you have some kind of microporosity quite loose, and this one is more dense. You see graphite layers are quite dense. But here it is very important to see that this material in the lower magnifications has some kind of chain structure, whereas here you see some particles which are disconnected. It will play a role for conductivity, but also for preparation of electrode as a flexible plate. Here on this slide, you see some BT specific surface area for both material. It is a powder, and here electrode. Electrode is, of course, you are losing some porosity because of Teflon and some conducting additive. For YP also, electrode powder and electrode material, both. BET specific surface area slightly is diminishing, microporosity as well. But what is the difference, main one between two materials is that this one has mesoporosity, especially from 2 to 4 nanometers in this region. And this one has no mesoporosity at all, 0.1 only. So it is the biggest difference between these two materials. For particle size distribution, you see that YP, this Japanese material, has very homogeneous one size of particles, around 10 micrometer, where adenine, KZ material, has very broad particle size distribution, but it improves some interparticle contact. Here you see some composition of this material by XPS and by elemental analysis. In this material, nitrogen by XPS is 4.6%, whereas by elemental analysis is double more, 9.4, because it is some kind of quaternary nitrogen which is present in the matrix. You see here that pyrolytic nitrogen and pyridinic is around 16%, whereas quaternary is very high amount, 54%. So half of nitrogen in our material originates from quaternary nitrogen. Nitrogen is quaternary here and improves very much conductivity of our material. Here you see electrochemistry, cyclic voltammetry with different type of scan rate from 1 to 50 millivolts per second. You see perfect square shape voltammogram, very nice. Here you see some separation of negative electrode and positive electrode, also very nice square shape voltammogram. Whereas going from 1.5 volt, you see some kind of pseudo-capacitive properties, which is visible here, some additional growth. And here, separate the negative and positive, you see also some kind of irregular voltammogram. The most important slide is presented here, where you see capacitance versus frequency. So at 1.5 volts, our capacitance with adenine keeps very nicely capacitance until 1.7 farad per gram. So it is very nice charge propagation. Whereas for YP, you see that capacitance is already lost at 1 hertz, has only 42. So definitely higher drop of capacitance. If you will compare long-term cyclability, so for YP50F carbons, you see very nice cyclability, the same as for adenine. So both of them, they have very good long-term stability. And during, before aging and after aging, you see what is changing some physicochemical properties. So specific surface area slightly dropping, especially for positive electrodes. For negative, this drop is lower. And you see here that positive electrodes losing slightly properties as well. We also compare some kind of density of those materials and conductivity. So conductivity measured by dried electrodes is shown here scheme. You see here 8 millisiemens per centimeter and YP40 4.3. So definitely better conductivity for our new materials. However, density, you see that there is double smaller. The same material, but by electrochemical impedance spectroscopy measuring in Schwarz log, you see that for ESR, equivalent series resistance is 0.6, the same for both materials. But here you see around 0.9 ohm for equivalent distributed resistance, where here you have 3. So again, adenine is better for this parameter. For low frequency, it means 1 millihertz, which reflects very low regime, 0.1 ampere per gram. You see the parameter as the following. Gravimetric capacitance is better for adenine, but volumetric is definitely better for YP because it is more dense. But if you want to use our material for high frequency, it means for mobile application, it means for electromobility, where you are using 10 ampere per gram, both materials are comparable concerning volumetric capacitance, and even gravimetric capacitance is definitely better for adenine. So it is playing perfect role for both applications, finally, stationary and electromobility. Unfortunately, self-discharge for adenine is bigger because we are losing from 1.5 volt until 0.9 volt. And here for YP, because there is lack of self-dysfunctionality, self-discharge is lower. It drops to 1.2 volts. And of course, leakage current is also bigger for adenine, so there is some kind of disadvantage. As a conclusion, our new material from adenine shows only very small drop of capacitance going from 1 millihertz to 1 hertz, owing to special morphology, which was shown by transfer electron microscopy. This gravimetric capacitance was very high, equal to 140 farad per gram, because of good porosity, ultra, but also small mesoporos and nitrogen functionality. High conductivity was reached because of nitrogen, optimal amount 9.4%, weight percent, and its modification of electronic structure. Lifespan was good for both materials. They are going very nicely with during floating and during cycling. So this work was done in the cooperation between three institutions, University of Saragossa, National Institute of Chemistry Slovenia, and our university, Poznan University of Technology. Thank you very much for your attention.